All right, let's get back to work now that that little detail is taken care of. I mean, I like that mini game. I think it's really fun, but I could have done a lot better. I mean, I almost lost the first fight where it was just one round. Like, I just barely won. Like, I guess it's the recording curse, you know, where you're really good at a game, but when you try to record yourself, you do bad. Anyway, let's take out this snowman before he tries to murder me. There we go. And that's the last snowman of the level. Like, there was really only two of them. But yeah, I think that's the first enemy in the game we've really encountered that Spyro's normal attacks cannot kill. I could be wrong. Correct me if that is so. And right here, we have a third laser tower, but we don't really need to use it. Like, I can just run around and kill these mammoths the normal way. See that? No laser required. And where's the fodder? You can't escape me. Die! So if we go around here, we can have some, we can find some gliding positions, because there are some gems along the outer walls of all these buildings that we have to, find. Let's see. Get this egg. Jasper. And I fell off. Which means I have to go through the entire level again. Because we haven't gone completely through the main part of the level, so whatever little path we could open to get back to the start quickly is pretty much non-existent. And yes, I did screw up by killing that one Rhinoc. But, you know, that's not that big of a deal. I'll just edit in getting the gems and everything. Like, I'll just post-edit all that stuff. Still, like, I had a sneaking suspicion. I was like, as soon as I killed that Rhinoc earlier, I was like, I think I messed up. And yeah, I did. It's kind of dickish, if you think about it. You know, because not everyone will get immediately that you're supposed to use that frozen enemy as a platform. And why can't I glide to this platform without failing? Come on, let's do this right. I don't know, maybe there is a way for me to get those gems, you know, without having to use the frozen Rhinoc trick. You know what? Let's go ahead and get the main egg so we can actually, you know, open up the entire level.
Thanks for helping out, Spyro. Why don't you take this? The Rhinocs were trying to fry it with a laser, but you stopped them just in time.
Good to know. Alright, so that door is open, which basically completes the main part of the level. However, guess who's here?
Say, Spyro, you're a sports fan, aren't you? As you probably know, Frozen Altars is the birthplace of the great sport of cat hockey. Today's match is sold out, of course, but I just happen to have a spare ticket that I'll sell you for, say, a teensy weensy markup?
A teensy weensy markup. $800 to enter the cat hockey rink. Sure, I love cat hockey. I don't know what it is, but we'll go with it.
Head on in, Spyro. It should be a thrilling match. In fact, I've even placed a little wager on the Rhinoch team. Let's just hope the local team doesn't have any last-minute accidents.
You're a dick. Have I said that already? I'm sorry. Let me say it again. You're a dick. Anyway, let's go inside. Whoa! It's like a candy dispenser. Those poor cats. They're probably getting motion sick in there.
I challenged a Rhinoch to a traditional game of cat hockey, but I think I sprained my flipper during training. Would you mind taking my place?
Well, yeah, last second accident, of course. Alright. Let's play some cat hockey.
Great. Freeze the cats and push them into my goal to score.
What is with these penguins? Like, what's with the voicing here? It's like, yeah, you gotta play this game, man. Like, you gotta come smoke this stuff with me, man. I don't know, seriously. All right, push frozen cats into the blue goal. First one with five cats wins. This is crazy. All right, so in order to play this game, you gotta freeze a cat, and you have to push the frozen cat into your goal. You can also freeze the Rhinoch and sort of prevent him from getting to the cats. Oh, come on. Get over there. This is actually pretty easy once you really get down how to do it, but oh my god, he's actually going to tie me very soon if I don't get... Oh, come on. Game winner right here. Come on. Turn around. Get it in there. Yes!
Well done. I think you deserve to keep the Champions Cup.
That doesn't look anything like a cup. Well, that's one of the more interesting egg animations, and... What the heck? I guess that's supposed to be a scratching post for them? Like, what is with this game? For real. Yeah, I beat you. Yeah! How does it feel? Look, I'm gonna push him into his own goal. Own goal. Extra point for me. Okay, we're done here. Well, that didn't take very long. Like, I don't know if I really want to try to speak on the difficulty of that. It really depends, like, how well you do in that game sort of depends on where the cats go and what your opponent is doing and how well you place your cats or whatever. I don't know what I'm trying to say. But that challenge really isn't that bad. Okay. Make it crap. Yeah, I'm gonna have to actually leave just to get those last couple of gems. I'm not happy about that, but it looks like that is what will have to be done. Okay, can I at least make it over to this building? Now let me guess. Yes! Two gems! Two measly gems that I will have to leave and come back for. So, yeah, I guess I'll just do a quick jump cut and I'll just go straight to the... I'll do a quick cut and come back when I get those gems. So, give me a moment.
Hmm.
Well, see what I meant earlier about not being able to use Hunter? That's why I did Honey Speedway and Lost Fleet first before doing Frozen Altars. That's what I meant when I was saying in those episodes about how something was going to happen where Hunter would be unavailable. So, yeah. If you didn't do Honey Speedway or Lost Fleet up until this point where you lose Hunter, you're not going to be able to finish those levels for quite a while. But anyway, let me go back into Frozen Altars real quick, and I'm going to get those gems. Alright, so after freezing that Rhinoc and jumping on him, you want to glide over to here. And we've got all the gems. Level complete. However, there is still one last thing I want to show off, and I'll just cut to that real quick. Hey everybody, I'm back here at the Yeti boxing match here in Frozen Altars, and I actually have a nifty little Easter egg, a fun little thing to show off for you guys. That you can use to sort of make the Yeti fight super, super easy.
This time it'll be a free round match, and when you win, don't let him send you off with a stupid egg.
Alright, we begin the match, and the Yeti is just standing there. He's not even moving around. See, there's actually a little bit where if you plug in a second controller before going into the Yeti boxing match, this actually becomes a two-player game. So I've actually got the Yeti under the control of a second player, and so he's not doing anything, which makes him super easy to beat. So if you want an easy way to get the skill point for knocking the Yeti out in two rounds, you can just use this, you can just plug in a second controller and just have the Yeti stand there, and you can just wail on him over and over again. It makes it very easy to cheese your way past, you know, getting the skill point. Can I do it before the end of round one? Come on. Got him. Skill point, there it is. So yeah, I just had to show that off because it's a pretty cool little Easter egg, and plus it makes getting the skill point for that area very, very easy. But anyway, we are officially done with Frozen Altars, and it is time to leave. So let's do that, shall we? And now we have a nice round number, a nice gem total, and Atlas time. So here we go, Frozen Altars. We have done everything in the level, even though we had to make a second trip to get a few extra things. But we have gotten all the dragon eggs, all six of them, and all 600 gems, and a skill point. So Frozen Altars is completely done all the way through. And that bumps our totals to 9,100 gems and 97 dragon eggs for 63% completion. And you know what that means? It's time for us to cut it. So that is a wrap on this episode of Let's Play Spyro 3 Year of the Dragon for the PlayStation 1. We have done Frozen Altars all the way through. And in the next episode, we will start the next main level of Evening Lake. So this is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. If you folks liked what you saw in this episode, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it as always. And I'll see all of you in the next episode. Ultimate Lifeform. Like what you see in this video? Want to see more? Then please support my channel by liking, commenting, and subscribing. I would greatly appreciate it. And also, don't forget to like me on Facebook.